Right, grade five. This is our repeat pattern or our tessellation. If you have a look at the YouTube video, it'll give you an idea of what's going on, but I just want to show you what I did. Okay, so I cut out these shapes here. I drew them with pencil. I cut it out and I measured how far this was, and I measured it at the top, and I literally made a little marking over here, and I made sure I stuck this piece that I'd cut out exactly the same distance from this side at the bottom. Okay, from that side. So this distance and this distance are exactly the same. I then cut out this curve, this wave curve over here, and I again measured the distance from here to here, and I measured it here to there, and I stuck it exactly on top above on that side. You can see on all of these marks, on all of these sections that I've cut off, I've made a mark. I'm sure you can see the sticky tape there of how you can see that I've stuck everything together. Okay, so this is the first part that you need to master. So you need to have a square, cut out a square, then draw your shapes on, and then you need to cut the shapes out. This shape that was here goes exactly, you move it up to that side. This shape that's over here, you move that shape up to that side and measure the distance apart over here, and then stick them down. Okay, you can see the sellotape there. All right, then what you do is you take your cardboard or your piece of paper and you place it down. Okay, I've already colored mine in, and you place them down to form the pattern. So you can see that one is over here, and I just outlined it in pencil first before you do your whiteboard marker. Then I did the same over there again. You can see, and I joined it. It's like a puzzle piece, it fits together. Then what I did is I then had to match up this side, so I turned my piece of paper over to get that shape. Can you see? So on this line, I had to turn my piece of paper over there. And on this line again, the next line further down, I have to turn my paper to the other side, and I had to put it that way. So you keep flopping it and you make them fit into each other. This is called tessellation. You would have done this in maths. Okay, so the first step is to do this. Stick it together and start drawing your patterns. Don't forget to carry on with the outline. Okay, don't leave it open so that there's a plain border around your page. Make sure it all fits together nicely. Then I want you to complete the drawing by outlining with your whiteboard marker, or you can use a Cokie or Sharpie. It doesn't matter if it's permanent marker, provided you put a piece of paper underneath it so it doesn't stick to your parents' furniture. Okay, or doesn't mark your parents' furniture. So that's the first part that we're going to do. This is all we are going to do for today, because it's going to take you time. And then for the next lesson, we are going to color in this tessellation. Be patient, guys. Follow the instructions. It will help you. Thank you. Bye.